Hello everyone, it's Aeon from Low Expectation, and today let's talk about Marksman. Now, unlike its Beast Mastery brothers, the Marksman Hunter is not reliant on a pet, and instead focuses mainly on dealing heavy damage with a ranged weapon. They do this by having a unique passive called Lone Wolf. When you do not have a pet active, you gain 10% increased damage. You can still summon a pet if you really need to. Now, Marksman Hunters have two main mechanics. One is Focus. Focus works a lot like energy from rogues. It fills up over time and then you can spend it on certain abilities. However, unlike rogues, you're able to build Focus by using other abilities. So with Focus, you'll have three main abilities to spend it on. Aim Shot, Multi Shot, and Arcane Shot. Aim Shot is the most important. Once cast, this will grant you a buff called Precise Shots. This will buff your next one or two multi-shot or aim shots. The amount of stacks you get is random, so just keep an eye on it. Arcane Shot is for single target and multi-shot is for 3 plus targets. So the aim of the game is quite simple. Cast Aim Shot, then depending on what you're fighting, use your stacks of Precise Shot before casting another aim shot. Simple. Also, you have Kill Shot. You can only use this when the mob's below 20% health. Basically, just press it on cooldown for those big numbers. Now, Aim Shot has two stacks. Keep this in mind when weaving in your arcane and multi shots. Outside of this rotation, you'll be spending the rest of your time casting Steady Shot and Rapid Fire. Both of these spells are free and will build Focus. Make sure you prioritize Rapid Fire first and then Steady Shot when that's on cooldown. So the most common mistakes for Marksman Hunter is either capping on Focus or letting your aim shot sit at 2 stacks. Try to avoid this if you would like to increase your DPS. In this preview guide, we won't go in depth into rotations, but if that's something you're looking for, please check out the Wildhead guides and the Hunter's Discord. They have tons of information for you. So what are the main strengths of a Marksman Hunter? Probably the biggest strength is his incredible burst damage. At the start of combat, you are able to demolish targets with your true shot cooldown. This is perfect for vulnerability windows or if a dangerous add needs to be taken care of quickly. Honestly, Marksman Hunters wipe the floor with mobs whenever it wants. Talking about high burst damage, another one of your strengths is misdirect. Now please misdirect your tank before you decide to nuke a mob off the face of the planet. One, they will love you for the free threat, and two, it keeps them from chasing you. Now, as mentioned before, Marksman Hunters do not rely on having a pet, meaning that pesky AI that still bugs out after 16 years of development is something you don't have to worry about, unless they buff pets. Let's hope that doesn't happen. And finally is your mobility and defensive cooldowns. Marksman Hunters still don't have the mobility of their Beast Mastery brothers, but they are leagues above a lot of classes. Disengage and Aspect to the Teacher give you excellent options to deal with pesky boss mechanics. Alongside that, you have Aspect of the Turtle for an immunity and Survival of the Fittest for a 20% damage reduction. Combo your immunity and your mobility together and you're the perfect person to soak those boss mechanics. Sorry, I know it's not a fun job. Now, as great as you are, there are a few minor setbacks. One actually is your damage. As mentioned before, you are a nuclear bomb. However, once it's gone bang, your damage falls down. This can be a problem in certain boss fights if you need consistent boss damage. Just keep this in mind. Next is your pet. It's great to not deal with the pet AI, however, they do offer some unique utility. A ferocity pet can provide bloodlust and 10% leech, while a cunning pet can offer a CC break and a movement increase. Both useful in certain situations, so just be ready to pull them out if you need them. So that wraps up the basics of Marksman Hunter. However, in the Shadowlands, you are able to join a covenant and they will offer you a unique hunter ability, so let's go over them. Let's start with Kirion. You will gain Resonating Arrow. You fire an arrow at a target location that will create a blue circle for 10 seconds. Anything inside this circle can be hit even if they are not in line of sight. Yes, you heard me right, you have wall hacks. You also have a 30% increased critical strike chance to anything within the circle. Just a side note, even if they leave the circle, you can still hit them for 4 seconds. And if you join the Necrolodge, you will gain Death Chakram. Basically, throw some glowy chakrams at a target ninja style, they will deal damage and give focus back to you. The chakrams bounce 7 times, each time giving you focus and dealing damage. They can bounce all 7 times on a single target, so don't worry about mid-maxing. Basically, fire it on cooldown. And with the Nightfae, you will get Wild Spirits. Place down a circle at a target location. Anything within the circle will be marked and take 5% increased damage from you. Anytime you hit them with one of your damaging spells or one of your pet's damaging spells, they will take a burst of damage. This honestly looks like a firework display when you're doing AoE. And finally is Venthyr. They will offer you Flayed Shot. This is a 14 second dot on a 30 second cooldown. Each time the dot ticks, it has a chance to make the next kill shot you cast usable at any health, instead of just being an execute. It's quite boring, but it has some fun aspects. So that's Marksman. It's a nuclear bomb that clears packs of enemies in seconds. Combo that with your great utility, defensives and mobility, and you got yourself a class looking to smash the end game. Honestly, it's a breath of fresh air. Most classes in WoW have small numbers that get lost on the screen. The Marksman Hunter, however, has few numbers, but they are big and impressive, and honestly, feels great. Now, as usual, if you have any questions, please put them in the comment section below. I will answer everything. Don't forget to follow myself and the guild on social media, give the video a thumbs up and a subscribe, and until next time, guys, have a good one.